So now that we have seen how paging and virtual to physical translation works, let's talk about the memory access time when we have this translation. So our program does something like this. It says load R1 from the address computed by adding 4 to what is in R2. This, when computed, will be the virtual address that we want to access in the program. So to do a load or a store, the processor has to compute the virtual address. This is quick. Usually it's just addition of two numbers that are already in the processor. One is a constant fetched with the instruction. The other one is the register that is inside the processor. Next, the processor has to compute the page number, which is extremely quick because it just means that we take some bits from the virtual address. And without any address translation, the next thing that the processor will do is access the cache, and sometimes, if there is a cache miss, the actual memory. So again, these two are extremely quick. Most of the time will be spent accessing the cache, and occasionally we will spend more cycles because we need to access the memory. With virtual to physical translation, after computing the page number, the processor has to compute the physical address of the page table entry where the translation for the page number is. This is done by adding the page number that we computed to the beginning address of the page table. Then we read the actual page table entry and compute the physical address by combining the physical frame number from the page table entry with the page offset from the virtual address. So how fast is this? Well, this is fast because it just means adding the page number to some sort of address. This is fast because it only means combining two numbers that we already have. But how fast is this? And for that, we need to ask ourselves, so where is the page table? Is it inside the processor so it can be quickly accessed, or is it in memory? We have seen that the page table can be fairly large. Yes, for a multi-level page table, we can have it be less than a megabyte for some programs, but in theory, it can be extremely large. So we cannot guarantee that the page table for even one process fits on the processor chip, which means that the page tables really need to be in memory. And that means that for each load or store, we now need to have a memory access, which is just as slow as when we had a cache miss that we were trying to avoid before we got to page tables. Things are even worse because for a multi-level page table, for example, a four-level page table, we would need to do this multiple times. For example, 4 times. Compute the physical address of the outermost page table, read that entry, compute the physical address of the next page table, go ahead and do that 4 times. So we need 4 memory accesses to read the 4 page table entries until we get the actual translation, after which we can quickly access the cache. So somehow, we have a situation where the virtual to physical address translation is costing us more than the memory accesses that we try to avoid by having the caches.